In this video, we'll see how to draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of uniformly distributed load and uniformly varying load. The arrangement of the beam is as shown in the figure. So we are having uniformly distributed load of 2 kN per meter for 16 meter length and uniformly varying load from 0 to 2 kN per meter for 10 meter length. So we can say that it is having effective overhang on the left hand side of 10 meter and it carries uniformly varying load also. The first step will be to convert the uniformly distributed load and uniformly varying loads into point load. So first we'll consider the uniformly distributed load. Now as you can see, this is the rectangular distribution. So u.d.l load will be base into height, that is area of the rectangle. Base is 16, so this is the base and it is 16, and height is 2, so it is 16 into 2, that is 32 kilonewton. Now CG of rectangular, it lies at a distance of b by 2, so base is 16 meter, it will lie at the center of this, so it is at 8 meter. So we have converted the uniformly distributed load of 2 kN per meter into a point load of 32 kN acting at the center of 16 meter length, that is 8 meter. Now meaning of uniformly distributed load is, for 1 meter length the load is 2 kN, then for 16 meter it will be 16 into 2 kN. Now the next one is, we have to convert the uniformly varying load into a point load. Now as this is the triangular distribution, we are having the area of the triangle as 1/2 base into height. So base in this particular case is 10 meter and height is 2. So this is 1/2 10 into 2. Base is 10 and height is 2. So this is 10 kilonewton. 10 kilonewton. Now we know that the CG of the triangular or triangular lamina, it lies at a distance of b by 3 from the base. So this is the base and this is the apex. From base it is lying at the distance of b by 3, or from apex it is lying at a distance of 2b by 3. So we are considering from the base. So location of the load, UVL load, is b by 3. So base is 10, so it is 10 upon 3. So uniformly varying load is of 10 kilonewton and it is acting at a distance of 10 upon 3 meter. So in this way we have converted UVL load into a point load of 10 kilonewton and it is acting at a distance of 10 upon 3 meter from B. Then the uniformly distributed load we have converted into point load of 32 kilonewton acting at a distance of 8 meter. Now next step is, we have to find out the values of reactions RB and RD. Now we will apply the conditions of equilibrium so that we can easily find out the reactions RB and RD. The first condition of equilibrium is summation of forces in y direction is equal to 0. Upward forces we have considered as positive, whereas downward forces we have considered them as negative. Now this 10 kN, 32 kilonewton, these are the active forces, and this reaction RB and RD, they are the reactive forces or reactions. Now these reactions, they will support this particular downward acting load, and therefore RB and RD, they are acting in the upward direction. The forces which are acting in the upward direction, they are positive. So RB and RD, they are positive, whereas this 10 kilonewton, 32 kilonewton, they are acting in the downward direction and hence they are negative. So we can say that RB plus RD is equal to 42 kilonewton. Now the next step is, we have to find out, we have to apply the another condition of equilibrium so that we can easily find out one of the reaction. So suppose we take moment about point B. And we know that the another condition of equilibrium is summation of moment about B is equal to 0. Clockwise moments, we have considered them as positive. whereas anti-clockwise moment, they are considered as negative. Start from this RD. Now this RD, this is the upward arrow. It will produce anti-clockwise moment about B, and perpendicular distance between D and B is 4 plus 16, that is 20. And this anti-clockwise moment will consider them as negative. So we can say that this will produce anti-clockwise moment about point B, and hence it is negative, and the distance is 4 plus 16, that is 20. This 32 kilonewton will produce clockwise moment about point B, and 32 and 8 is the perpendicular distance, so it is 32 into 8. Whereas this 10 kilonewton force, it will produce anti-clockwise moment, so it is 10 into 10 upon 3 is the perpendicular distance. Doing some calculations, transferring this negative minus RD into 20 term on the right hand side, it will become positive, and we'll get the value of reaction at D is equal to 11.133 kilonewton. Now we have to substitute this value in equation 1 so that we can easily find out the value of RB. So RB plus RD is 42 kilonewton. Transfer this RD on the other side, it will become minus. RD we have already calculated as 11.133. So we can say that RB is 30.867 kilonewton. Using these values, we have to draw shear force diagram. So the values of RB and RD are mentioned on the diagram. So let us start with the shear force diagram calculations. Start from point A. At point A, shear force is zero because no other force is acting at point A. Shear force just at the left of the B. So left of the B, we have to take into consideration this uniformly varying load of 10 kilonewton without taking into consideration the upward acting reaction of 30.867 kilonewton. So shear force at left of the B is this u.v.l, which we have already converted into a point load of 10 kilonewton. Or we can say that the magnitude of this u.v.l is 10 kilonewton, and as it is acting in the downward direction, it is negative. So it is minus 10 kilonewton. Exactly at B, we have to add this upward acting reaction of RB 30.867 to this particular value. So it is minus 10 plus 30.867, that is 20.867 kilonewton. Shear force at C, we have to take into consideration the uniformly distributed load of 2 kilonewton per meter acting over 16 meter length, that is nothing but 32 kilonewton, 2 into 16, that is 32. So we have to take into consideration this 32 kilonewton force. And as it is acting in the downward direction, to this 20.867, we have added this minus 32. So it is minus 11.133 kilonewton. Just at the left of the D, without consideration this reaction, there is no other force that is acting between C and D. So whatever is the shear force at point C, the same will be at the left of D. So it is minus 11.133 kilonewton. Exactly at D, there is a reaction, upward acting reaction of 11.133. So that will get added to this negative value. So answer will be 0. Now using these values, we have to draw the diagram. Now as you can see over here, shear force diagram is changing its sign from positive to negative. So this is the point of zero shear. Now we have to find out this point of zero shear. Now shear force at any section xx which is at a distance of x from point A. Now this distance is x from A up to section xx. This distance is 10 meter. So obviously this distance will be x minus 10 meter. Now consider all the forces present on the left hand side of this section xx. So on the left hand side of this xx, there is a uniformly varying load of 0 to 2 kilonewton per meter, and its magnitude is 10 kilonewton. and 10 kN, and as it is acting in the downward direction, it is negative. 2 into x minus 10, that is the uniformly distributed load. So it is, and it is also acting in the downward direction, so it is minus 2 into x minus 10. And this RB, it is acting in the upward direction. So these are the three forces which are acting on the left hand side of section XX. Now shear force is zero at this particular section XX. So on the left hand side, we have substituted zero. Then on the right hand side, we have substituted the value of reaction RB, that is 30.867. Now simplify this. Transfer this minus 2 into x minus term on the left hand side, it will become positive, and minus 10 plus 30.867, that is 20.867. Therefore x minus 10 will be equal to, now this 2 is in multiplication, it will go on the other side in the division. Transfer this minus 10 also on the right hand side, it will become positive. So value of x that we will get is 20.433 meter. So we can say that at a distance of 20.433 meter from A, the shear force is zero. Now we'll find out the value of bending moment also at this section. Consider again all the forces on the left hand side of section XX. Start with this 10 kN. This will produce anti-clockwise moment. So this is already we have seen, correct? So it will produce anti-clockwise moment about section XX. And perpendicular distance from this to this will be 10 by 3 plus x minus 10. That is, this total perpendicular distance is nothing but 10 by 3 plus x minus 10. So force is 10 and perpendicular distance is 10 by 3 plus x minus 10. And as it is an anti-clockwise moment, it will be negative. This 2 into x minus 10 force, it will also produce anti-clockwise moment, and its perpendicular distance is half of this x minus 10, because this is rectangular distribution. So x minus 10 by 2. So force is 2 into x minus 10, and this perpendicular distance is x minus 10 by 2. So we are already saying that for rectangular distribution or for uniformly distributed load, the load will act at the center of this particular length. But this RB, it will produce clockwise moment about section XX, and the perpendicular distance between B and this section XX is x minus 10. So clockwise moments are positive, so RB into x minus 10. So 10 will have perpendicular distance as 10 by 3 plus x minus 10. This 2 into x minus 10 will have perpendicular distance of x minus 10 upon 2. And this RB will have perpendicular distance of x minus 10. Now put x is equal to 20.433, and if you simplify this, then you will get bending moment at section XX as 75.525 kN meter. Now we have to find out the bending moment at various points. Now we know that at the end of the beam, that is at point A and at point D, bending moment is zero. Bending moment at XX, as indicated here, it is already we have calculated this value. Now bending moment at B, so there is only one force, that is 10 kN, and again it will produce anti-clockwise moment about B. So 10 into 10 by 3, that is minus 33.333 kN meter. Bending moment at C, consider all the forces on the left hand side of C. So this will produce anti-clockwise moment, and perpendicular distance is this 10 by 3 plus 16 up to point C. Then this 32, it will produce anti-clockwise moment. This 32, it will act at the center of 16 meter, that is 8 meter. This we have already seen. This RB will produce clockwise moment about point C, and perpendicular distance is 16. Substituting the value of RB as 30.867 kN, we'll get value of bending moment at point C as 44.538 kN meter. Using these values, we can easily draw the bending moment diagram. Now here also the bending moment diagram is changing its sign from negative to positive, and this is the point of contraflexure where bending moment is changing its sign. We can find out this particular value. Suppose we extrapolate this as section YY and we'll consider all the forces which are acting on the left hand side of this section YY. So those all the forces are shown over here separately so that it will be easy for us to understand. So section YY is shown. So this section YY we have considered, and we have considered all the forces which are acting on the left hand side of this section YY. Okay. So on the left hand side there is a 10 kilonewton force. Then if this is Y, this distance is Y and this is 10, then the remaining distance is Y minus 10 and force will be 2 into Y minus 10 and it will be acting at the center of Y minus 10, that is Y minus 10 upon 2, and RB is there of 30.867 kilonewton. So this is the exaggerated diagram or enlarged diagram, we can say. The better word is enlarged diagram for this section. Correct. So this length is Y minus 10, that is indicated, and u.d.l is 2 kilonewton per meter, and this very small length is Y minus 10, which we have shown over here. So bending moment at this section YY will be this 10, it will produce anti-clockwise moment, and perpendicular distance is 10 by 3 plus Y minus 10. So that is indicated by this first term. RB, it will produce clockwise moment and its perpendicular distance is Y minus 10, minus this 2 into Y minus 10, it will produce anti-clockwise moment and its perpendicular distance is Y minus 10 by 2. Simplifying this, so minus 10 into 10 by 3, that is this value, minus 10 into Y, that is minus 10Y, minus 10 into minus 10, that is plus 100, 30.867, this is nothing but the value of RB into Y, minus 30.867 into minus 10, that is minus 308.67. This 2 and 2, it will get cancelled out. So it is Y minus 10 into Y minus 10, that is Y minus 10 bracket square. So Y minus 10 bracket square is Y square minus 20Y plus 100. Simplifying this, we will get the quadratic equation as Y square plus 0.867Y minus 142 is equal to 0. Solving this, we will get the value of Y as 11.49 meter from A. So in this way, we can find out the point of contraflexure also. And then we can draw the shear force and bending moment diagram in case of simply supported beam carrying uniformly distributed load and uniformly varying load. Thank you very much for watching.